Stretch blow molding is a manufacturing process used to create PET bottles and jars. Small pellets of resin are pushed through an extruder and get melted. Then, they are injected into a steel mold that shapes them into what looks like a plastic test tube. These preforms are the starting point for all our plastic PET bottles. By injecting air into this heated preform, the bottle shape comes to life as it stretches to fill the bottle mold. There are two types of stretch blow molding techniques, single stage and the two-stage process. In the one or single stage process, preforms are created and then blown into bottles in one continuous process, all done by one machine. The process is split into three stations. First, melted plastic is injected into the preform mold. Then, it is switched to the second station for conditioning. And finally, at the third station, air is blown inside the heated preform, stretching the plastic into the mold and our desired bottle shape. Even though molding the preform is, technically, the slowest part of the process, each station is allotted the same amount of time since it's all part of one continuous process. This technique is often used in applications that call for higher quality or a specialized shape, such as wide mouth jars, where high production rates are not as essential. In the two-stage process, we break up the three stages of molding into two machines that work independently, allowing us to manage throughput more efficiently. Preforms, which take longer to make, can be produced by one machine and then warehoused for later production. Then, a batch of preforms can be loaded into another machine, called a reheat blow or RHB machine, which is specialized for blowing preforms into bottles in high quantities. This process provides a faster production rate and the potential to lower piece costs. Interested in a custom PET bottle or jar for your brand? Construct your design to work within our existing library of preforms, and custom PET bottles are within reach of many budgets. So, which production process is best suited for your product?